So I want to say bonjour. We all said is nakas. Mon pays on the common accounting. Jean Carre, on Jaba. I want to acknowledge the pipes and the Eagle staff and member First Nations flags, all the sacred items, and the fact that we're on the traditional territory of Anishinabek, which has been mentioned, happens to be my home. So welcome everybody to the 2016 Grand Council, which has its theme, Traction, Not Inaction. This is, of course, a reference to our restoration of jurisdiction process to put in place an Anishinaabek jurisdiction over education. But that traction, not inaction, can apply to all the work that we're doing. You know, we have a lot of work to do with a lot of very many priorities, and we need to get traction. So we're at a critical time right now for doing something great for our children. We have a golden opportunity to make things happen by taking over control of how education services are delivered in our communities. We've been talking about that for over 40 years with Indian control of Indian education. Actually, it started in Chigging. Our neighbors here were those kinds of talks started, and it spread right across the Anishinaabek territories, right across the country, embraced the need for us to take over education. And so we have a fantastic model that's taken over 20 years to develop. So with the Anishinaabek education system, we will have secure, predictable funding and automatic top-ups if the federal government raises its education budget for anyone else across the country. Something we've built into this agreement is that we will, if there's any enhancement anywhere in the country on education, we get it as well. So it's a good budget. There'll be guaranteed funding for student literacy, numeracy, retention, school success plans, and measurement for student success. We can make our own education laws. We can build a team of educators and approve the Anishinaabek education system, which will implement a school program that includes the Anishinaabek culture, language, and history. Kinemazwin Education Body will act like a school board and provide services to First Nations schools. It will handle relations with provincial schools that Anishinaabek students attend. Kinemazwin Education Body will take direction from the First Nations. That's the key important part of this thing, is that it will provide advice, but it will not tell a First Nation what to do. The regional education councils are the important element that directs what happens with the education of our children. Those are your representatives of your communities. It'll be your representatives of your communities that sit on the Kinemazwin Education Body as well. So you'll have a double-pronged attack of how to address the needs of your children. Money will flow from Canada to the Kinemazwin Education Body and then to the Anishinaabek First Nation. It'll not come to the UOI. So this is going out to the communities for your work. If you have any questions or concerns about what's happening, about the timeline, the process, or the model itself, we've established a number, and this number is really important for our people in our communities to call 1-877-497-3799 or visit www.sayyestoaes.ca. So we have to show accountability and transparency, you know, in our communities. Remember who we work for. Let's make sure everyone's encouraged to vote. Let's let the people decide. You know, let's not be a bottleneck. Let's let the people decide what's best for their children and their children and their grandchildren. Let's let the people decide. So it's time to move ahead. Traction, not inaction. Say yes to AES. And let's ensure that we create a great future for our children and our grandchildren and generations yet unborn. Chumigwech.